RPG Chick back with another episode of Let's Play Whispered World Blind. We're in a village on the island of Kalida, across a rope bridge, and there's one guy here. We told him that we need to stop the world from collapsing or something like that, and he said no matter what we do, we can't cheer him up. So I don't know why we care if the world's going to collapse. Anyway, who are you?
Who are you?
My name is... my name is Bando.
What?
Bando.
Come again?
Bando. Bando.
Waldo?
Bando! My name is Bando. Holy mackerel! I am Bando!
Bando! How often did I tell you to keep it down?
Look what you've done now. We woke the boss.
Oops.
He's sure to punish me for that.
Oops, the boss. Who's the boss here?
Who's the boss here?
That would be Ruben. He owns this island. You can find him in the house on the hilltop.
On the hilltop?
Yeah. Way up.
Phew.
Hey, little man. I thought you wanted to save the world.
You'll
have to get off your backside for that, you know.
Yes, yes. All right. No sweet without sweat, right?
Excuse me.
That's right. It will pay off in the end.
Pay off? It doesn't exactly look that way now. More like the opposite. Every step I take brings me nearer to the end. There's also the fear that my dream could come true. That the ground collapses and the world crumbles right under my feet.
Bando's gonna forget that. Think you forgot him.
At the hilltop, you said?
Yes. Way up.
Great. Thanks.
Why are you so unhappy, anyway?
Why are you so unhappy? Does the impending end of the world bother you, too? The thought that all could soon be over?
Oh, no. That's something for others to ponder. I don't care if the end is coming. On this island, we're done for anyway. You see, there's nothing to do anymore.
What do you mean there's nothing to do anymore?
What do you mean there's nothing to do anymore?
It's been quiet here since the boss closed the factory.
Factory?
Pearls used to be pressed here, but
Ooh.
The production has been discontinued.
Oh. I see. Why is that?
Well, the boss met his goal, 10,000 pearls. And now he's afraid of losing everything. What he fears most is that someone could wake Kalida. He's really paranoid. I can't make the slightest sound anymore. It used to be different. I was allowed to do the most thrilling jobs. I used to blow the foghorn in the House of the Howls. And come noon, I was allowed to ring the bell, which sounded all over the entire island. But the most thrilling job was the work in the factory. Hot air, thick smoke, and the noise of massive machinery drowning everything out. Whoom! Kaboom!
Bando! What's going on down there? Be quiet, will you? Or do you want Kalida to wake up?
Oh dear. You see what I mean? The good old days are over. Ah, well.
Now we know why they took the rope off the bell. About those former jobs of yours.
The good old days. What do you want to know?
What was that about the House of the Howls? That sounded pretty cool.
What was that about the House of the Howls?
Those were the days. Every time big boats came to the island, I was allowed to sound the big horn. Toot! 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 Bando watches over this lake. His call sounds as far as Corona.
You're gonna get
toot,
yelled at again.
Toot! 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 Toot!
Bando! How often do I have to tell you? Be quiet, will you?
Well, those days are over now.
Well, he's yelling too. Tell me about the factory.
What was that about the factory again?
Those were the days. I had the fastest shovel on this side of the autumn forest. What I liked best was to shovel coal in the heat of the furnace. Above me, the ear-deafening noise of the pearl press.
Wham! Boom! Look here, Mother Nature! Your masterpiece is being surpassed by the power of muscles and machinery!
Bando, I'm warning you!
Nothing lasts forever.
Yet the guy yells back at him. So what about the bell again?
What was that about the bell again?
Those were the days. I used to run to the entrance of the village every noon to sound the bell for lunch. The sound traveled all over the lake.
Okay, what did it sound like?
Dong! 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 Listen here, inhabitants of the lake! Bando tells you that it's time for lunch! Put away your worldly chores! It's time to eat now! Dong! Dong! Dong!
Bando! One more disturbance and I'll go nuts!
Those days are long gone.
Couldn't you learn something different?
Couldn't you learn something different?
Something different?
Something besides.
Exciting. Ah. What do you propose?
You could become a drummer.
You could become a drummer.
Drummer? I bet I'd be a great drummer. I could play the barrel drum in an orchestra.
What's it sound like?
I'd be louder than anyone else! And the cello players would get to feel my drumstick. The audience would go crazy.
That was dirty.
Bando!
Bando!
I can hear them holler, even now. Bando!
Bando! Be quiet already!
Yeah, you know what? I think I'd better skip that. I don't think Ruben would approve.
Would approve? You could go into road construction.
You could go into road construction.
That's not a bad idea.
Jackhammer.
The streets here could use a makeover. And who could do the job better than I? Cobblestone after cobblestone would have to be pounded into the soil.
Wham! Wham! Listen here, oh world! This island will soon have a new road! And after the road is finished, there'll be a bridge to build! And after the bridge, a tunnel directly to Corona! And finally, a master of road construction will rule again! Hooray to Bando! The master of road construction! Hip hip hooray!
Bando, I'm about to lose my patience with you!
Loose my patience.
My fantasies just got the better of me.
You could be a market crier.
You could be a market crier.
Market crier? Wow, I always wanted to be a market crier as a child. I would run through the village with a full basket of pears and cry,
apples, apples!
I don't even know why. I mean, they were pears after all. But I didn't care.
Apples! I'd cry, buy from Bando! From Bando, the daredevil market crier! Apples! Apples! Bando's exploding apples!
Bando! I'm fed up with your noise!
Oh dear. I should stick to my limitations.
You could be in the opera.
You could be in the opera.
Well, why not? I've got the looks.
We're deliberately
getting
him in trouble.
Women would fall at my feet, and men would envy me. I'd break glass after glass with my voice.
Really now?
Shatter!
Sunglasses, water glasses. I'd even shatter the dome of the firmament itself.
Bando, do I always have to get mad first?
Philistine.
You could open a circus.
You could open a circus.
I don't know about that. I mean, look at your rags. I don't want to make a fool of myself in front of all the people.
You wouldn't have to be the clown.
Hmm. That's right. I could be in the lion taming act. The lion tamer would have a hard time taming me.
Oh, you want to be the lion?
Bando! One more sound, and you'll be confined to your chamber. What on earth is going on down there?
Nothing, Ruben!
Roar.
I'm running out of ideas.
Don't take it too hard. I had already given up hope.
Yes, that's the effect I often have on people. About those...
I want to see what happens if he gets confined.
What was that about the bell again?
I used to run the sound...
Dong! Listen here! Put away your... Dong!
Bando! One more disturbance at...
those days...
Nah, okay.
Just forget it.
Done. Anything else?
I'm looking for Kalita.
Who are you looking for? Kalita? You're a real clown, aren't you?
Why? What's strange about that? No, wait. Let me guess. Kalita is dead, or she never existed.
No. Kalita exists all right, but you'd better leave her alone.
So where can I find her?
So where can I find Kalita?
I already told you. Leave her alone. It'd be best if you didn't make any noise, so you don't wake her up.
I'm not supposed to do what? Wake her up? So she's grumpy in the morning? So what? What's the big deal? Will she throw her pillows and complain about the coffee?
Right. Or she could change into her full height and lay destruction upon the village. Just believe me, you don't want to wake Kalita.
I'm beginning to wonder myself.
Is she the island itself? Are we walking, like walking on her? Is there another way to leave this island?
I'm afraid not, but relax. We have all we need here.
Except company, of course.
That's right. There aren't many people living on the island.
And the lust for life?
Is somewhat limited.
The freedom to go wherever you want?
Yeah. Okay. We might not have all we need, but we have everything else.
I have to find Kalita, though. The world will collapse if I don't.
The world will collapse if I don't.
Do whatever you want, but I'm not helping you. I don't want any trouble, and I don't want to be blamed when disaster strikes us.
Just a moment. I don't want that either.
So you better let her sleep.
I'll see you later.
Yeah, later. But please keep in mind,
don't wake Kalita.
Nice and quiet. Like me. I, Bando!
Be quiet down there!
Oh, plenty of stuff to look at here. A flower. He's gonna say something depressing about it.
One day, this will shrivel and die too.
Yep.
People say that flowers flourish better when you talk to them. I tried and, well, maybe it depends on what you talk about. I'd better leave it where it is. My flowers always wither. Ben says it's my charisma.
You have a very low self-esteem.
The way things work out here, I suppose the key will eventually be useful. Sometimes my whole life seems like a locked door. What kind of key is this?
That's the key to the House of the Howls.
Cool.
Ruben has ordered me to watch it closely. Hold it, my friend. The key stays where it is. Ruben has ordered me to watch it closely. And you can always rely on Bando.
I thought I was going to start yelling again. Alright, so we need a distraction for Bando.
Everywhere I look, I see only locked doors and obstacles.
The door's open, Sadwick.
I don't give a whistle about doors. But then, how could I, not being able to whistle? I'm sure I could use one of those. After all, it seems to go downhill all the time. Can I borrow the ladder?
Of course. I'm not using it.
Tall enough not to?
Vertigo.
Great, so we just stuck that in our pocket.
Maybe they want to climb a social ladder, too. Seems to stand rather solid. No, I only need the ladder to reach remote things.
Okay, whoops. Sorry about that. I meant to exit out of that. Wait, which one's spot? Oh, there's a mouse hole here. That's what I was looking for.
The mouse hole is dark and empty, very much like my future.
You need therapy.
Hey, you got a mouse.
Of course I got a mouse.
And I must scream!
One more time.
Hey, you got a mouse.
Of course.
And
guy didn't yell at you this time. Hello?
I'd only scare the mouse away. I need some kind of bait.
Why do we want the mouse?
Hey, you got a mouse.
And
sometimes I wish I could hold up too.
This is actually an in-joke. I just caught it. I have no mouth and I must scream is an old adventure game. A 90s game, I believe it was.
Hey, you got a mouse.
Of course I got a mouse.
And I must scream!
Oh, we got a tooth out of this rug.
A rug with teeth. Again, seems to be all the rage nowadays. I'm quite happy that my own jaws are a little less obtrusive.
Take tooth. Cool, so we got like a knife type thing again.
The shovel is broken. I can't do much with it in this condition. No. Can you make use of this?
I wouldn't know what for. All the jobs have been done.
Watch where you're crawling, Spot. There are sharp objects poking out of the floor.
May I see that? That seems to be a sturdy shovel you've got there. Too bad it's broken. It seems to be exactly like the one that I've lost.
I won't be able to blame that on Spot. Good thing I taught Spot how to use ladders. Can I really borrow the ladder?
Yeah, go ahead.
We could whack him over the head with a shovel, and then grab the key.
I'd only scare the mouse away.
Okay. Let's go talk to, what's his name? Where is he, this guy? Ooh, an axe.
I hope that's used for chopping wood. That'd be the only way to make me smile today.
Cool. Got an axe.
That'd be the only...
What, to carve a smile into your face with the axe? I just got that.
I hope that... I can't cut it down twice. No. The hook is pointy enough.
A A broken cogwheel.
It's broken right through the middle. Everything is breaking down.
Entropy,
There are some teeth missing here, but I'm still using mine for grinding, mostly.
Oh, you dirty guy.
It does need some complicated mechanism. All broken. No. There's no hidden mechanism as far as I know.
Our collection is beginning in earnest again.
There's a cogwheel missing. No wonder the door's not working. They're not teeth that are missing. It's a cogwheel. There's a cogwheel missing. No wonder. This seems to be part of the door's mechanism. But it's broken.
He seems like he's looking right at me. Oh, he's a vice.
My head feels like it's clamped into one of these.
Somehow I doubt that.
It reminds me of the braces I once had to wear. Whoa. I'm getting all woozy thinking about it.
That's why that door won't work. Oh, well, you gave that away. I didn't even know there was a door there.
My head feels like it's clamped. It reminds me of the wall. No, that doesn't need to be repaired. No.
Thought I had it.
I think I can repair the shovel without a vise. All I need is a proper handle.
I know there's a lever there. Let's look in this cabinet.
I wonder what's in there. A trapdoor? A tiger? The gates of hell? Could be anything.
Yeah, inside a cabinet, the gates of hell.
Hello? A closed-off type of guy, this cabinet.
Ah! Oh, hello. Do you...
What was that? A bird?
Do you lay those eggs?
What did you do it there?
Do you lay those eggs?
Hello? Is there... obviously not.
Not anymore.
Empty. If there was anything in there, a little bird must have eaten it. A door. I wonder where it leads to. I should talk to Bando about it. He'll know how this thing works. Strange. I don't see a handle. Well, let's see. No, not a chance. I don't think it can be opened by hand. What? Phew. It's just a lever. For a moment, I thought it was an angry cave troll.
Oh my god, Sadwick. Okay.
I should talk to Bando about it. He'll know how this thing works.
Talk to Bando about a lot of things.
Nothing. Spot can't help me with this. It has nothing to do with either indigestion or the destruction of foreign property. Hey, Spot, I think I have an idea. Come here for a moment, will you? What's that? Insubordination? I'll show you. Hey, Spot, can you find a way to the opposite side? You ninny. I was talking about another way. One that isn't blocked. Okay, okay. Maybe I can find a way to open the door. Spot isn't a great help here, I'm afraid.
He just had a whole conversation all by himself. Well, basically, if we find the other part of the cog, I'm guessing we could also put it in the vise and use Spot to melt the pieces together. go talk to Bando. Where's that bird? Where'd that bird go to?
Hi again.
Oh, it's you again. What else can I do for you?
I don't know. Maybe you can answer some questions. Where does the door in the adjoining room lead to?
The door leads to the other side of the island, but we don't go there anymore.
Why not? Has a big monster walk abroad there? Is there a volcano? Cannibals? You're not able to open the door anymore.
You nailed it.
And where's Ruben? Why doesn't the door in the adjoining room open anymore?
It's a mechanical security door. It's a great gadget. It works with steam and cogwheels, you see.
Not entirely.
Yes, it's quite complicated and state of the art. I would love to show you, but unfortunately, the cogwheels are broken and the steam came from the factory when it was still running.
So the door cannot be opened at all?
No. At least for the time being.
It's a shame. It seems to be a great piece of engineering.
What kind of birds are these?
Oh, I like the Yakis. They can sing beautifully loud.
Yakis.
I even tried to imitate their song on the foghorn. But Ruben forbade me. He likes the fact that they don't dare to come to the village. They disturb his sleep. Also, he's afraid their singing could wake Kalida. That's why he allows Mulahai to put up all those candles. The Yakis are afraid of the light, you know.
Aha. So it's the light of the candles.
The light of the candles scare them away. Okay. Now we've got a portable little candle with us as well. What kind are they again?
What kinds of birds are these again?
Cute little animals. And very musical. Ruben is afraid they could wake Kalida. That's why he allows Mulahai to put up all those candles. The Yakis are afraid of the light, you know.
See you later.
Yeah, later. But please keep in mind, be not like me.
Be quiet down there!
We will chop our way through the gate. Well, the door.
The door's built too strongly to pry open. Either that, or I'm too weak.
Too weak? I didn't want you to pry it. I wanted you to chop it up.
The door's built too high.
Go over.
I don't see how that's supposed to help me open the door. It's operated by some...
I want to go over the door. Alright. Let's get out of here. We also need to get a mouse. Maybe he's yelling from down there. There's a window.
There's a light shining. I can't make out more details from here. Hello? Is somebody up there?
Probably.
No answer. No chance. I'm not very good at climbing, I'm afraid. Spot can't give me a boost. He doesn't have any hands.
I wanted to give him a boost.
What? Where?
That'll wake Kalita.
Who dares to disturb my well-deserved sleep?
Hello.
It is
what
I.
What are you looking at?
Clowny.
Come here. Who are you? What's your business here? I don't want to hear your life story, so make it snappy, okay? I want to sleep!
I'm Sadwick, and you?
I'm Sadwick. And you?
Ha! If you're selling anything, you're not very well prepared. Obviously, I am Ruben.
Oh.
I own this island.
That's Ruben.
But I'm not selling anything.
Now, that's a fortunate coincidence, because we don't need anything. So you may as well go back to where you came from.
I can't. You look tired.
You look tired.
Sleeping is my favorite pastime. It's a privilege for people who have accomplished everything. Unfortunately, I have to sleep at this table because my bed is squeaking terribly. But why do I bother to tell you all this? The thing that now keeps me from having my well-deserved nap is not the squeaking bed, and it's not the yakis, the machinery in the factory, or my rumbling manservant either.
Bando.
No, it's an annoying child in a clown's costume who bursts into my office without having been asked and keeps talking and talking. Good grief! My head is about to explode with all this blather.
You're the one talking and talking. What kind of buildings are those out there? Some kind of factory?
What kind of buildings are those out there? Some kind of factory?
You bet your baubles. The pearl factory has been here for ages. Thousands and thousands of pearls have been pressed here under my supervision. To be more accurate, there are exactly 10,000, and not one less. Not one more either. But the most important thing is, there's not one less. Each one is more perfect than the other.
If you're showing the pearls, why isn't the factory still producing them?
Didn't you listen? I don't need any more pearls. I've got them all. All 10,000.
Why don't you have more pearls made?
Why don't you have more pearls made?
What kind of a question is that? Are you really that stupid? Nor is it part of the clown act. Why on earth would anybody need more than 10,000 pearls? More than 10,000 pearls. Listen to this screwball.
Sheesh. I have to get to Corona. How can I leave this island?
I have to get to Corona. How can I leave this island?
You can't. There's no connection to the mainland. We are completely self-sufficient.
So I'm stuck here?
In that case, I hope you're good at other things. Besides looking stupid, we can't use a clown here, you know. And I haven't exactly been laughing my head off either. But I'm sure we'll find a way for you to make yourself useful tomorrow.
I can't stay here. I have to prevent a disaster.
If you really want to prevent a disaster, you'll shut up right now and let me sleep. Get it?
How can you do nothing? The world is at stake.
How can you do nothing? The world is at stake.
Dear Lord, please, not one of those do-gooders again. Why do you think the world is on the edge? It's because there's always somebody who wants to change things. If everything stays the way it is, then nothing happens. And if nothing is happening, then nothing bad happens. Ever. It's a simple calculation. You can do it on a single sheet of paper.
Uh-huh. That's a cute pet you have there.
That's a cute pet you have there. What's its name? It doesn't happen to be, Kalita.
No. His name is Carrot.
Nice name. I bet Carrot and Spot would get along very well. Can he do any tricks? Spot can change into the most diverse forms.
Carrot can slay creatures in the most diverse ways.
Oh, so we'd better not let them play together.
In fact, Carrick is not here to play. He makes sure that no riffraff is roaming about while I'm asleep. I don't even like to think about someone messing with my pearls.
Where can I find Kalita? This is gonna go over well, isn't it?
Where can I find Kalita?
Why do you want to know? Listen well. Kalita is mine. Keep your hands off her. You hear?
Did I get that right? You're holding Kalita as a prisoner? Where? Up there?
What's up there is none of your business. And by the way, what do you want from Kalita?
She's supposed to help me to get the Corona.
What's she supposed to do?
You'd better forget it. Kalita mustn't be woken up. And God help you if I find out you tried anyway. I'll order Bando to feed you to the Yakis immediately.
Hmm. But I have to find Kalita. The world will end if I don't.
I have to find Kalita. The world will end if I don't.
I said forget it.
Ah.
If you want to get to Corona, you'll have to swim. And whatever you do, I'll stop you from disturbing Kalita's rest.
Hmm. Can I look upstairs?
Can I look upstairs?
What do you want? Are you out of your mind?
Maybe.
Keep your nose out of my private rooms, you clown. I am an accessible man. But if you mess with my personal belongings, I'll have you thrown off the highest cliff.
Accessible?
And believe me, I mean it.
Okay. I met a monk at the store. At the shore, sorry.
I met a monk at the shore.
Mordecai? Just ignore the old crackpot. I believe he thinks he's enlightened or something. I say he's not. Sneaks around everywhere lighting candles. Ha! As if he'd try to show all the world what a dim light he is. Whatever. I let him live on the remote side of the island. He may as well. He's not disturbing anyone back there, and he keeps the Yakis away at least.
You want him to light the candles because that keeps the Yakis away so that the Yakis don't make all kinds of noise and wake up Kalita. But anyway, what are Yakis?
What are Yakis?
Annoying little creatures. Those flying rodents have kept me from sleeping more than once. You'd probably get along with them very well. In fact, they look as foolish as you. Thank God they don't dare come to this side of the island most of the time. They dread the light, which unfortunately is more than can be said about you.
We like light. What about the remote side of the island?
The remote side of the island?
Yes. We don't go there anymore. And the door has been out of order since the factory was stopped. You could try to find a way there. The more I think about it, the better the idea seems to be. You would get along perfectly on the other side of the island. With Molokai, with the Yakis, and all the other things that we don't want on this side.
In that case, see you later.
See you later.
Exactly. Just let me sleep in peace.
Oh, wow. Well, tune in next episode when we don't let him sleep in peace and start messing with everything in this room. See you then. And a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.